Hello everyone, it's Lynn, and do you see this little guy? This is Bob, and I animated him in Adobe Fresco and Premiere Pro. In my videos, I love creating hand-drawn animations to add more personality and charm to each frame. Whether it's a character that interacts with the environment of a shot, or a title sequence with sparkles and pizzazz, these doodles can take your storytelling to the next level, and it's easier than you think. Today, I'll take you through the basics of hand-drawn animations and how I use them to emphasize movement, convey a message, and create cool transitions. First, before you jump into drawing, let's take a look at your footage in Adobe Premiere Pro and see what we're working with. Where can animation supplement and support your story? Is there an action or dialogue you want to highlight? Is there a feeling that isn't captured in the footage itself, such as a gust of wind or the first few notes of a song? I also like to rough cut and color grade my footage beforehand so I can get a better understanding of the flow and possible color palettes. From there, you can compile a shot list of what you want to draw and animate. If this is your first time animating, congrats, that's exciting. I also recommend that you watch clips from your favorite animations to observe the mechanics of lines, shape, and movement. I am no professional animator myself, definitely not, but I find that even simple, organic animations can enhance your storytelling. First, let's talk about adding in animations to emphasize an action. In this frame, I purposely broke the tip of a color pencil to convey the feeling of frustration when you hit art block. While adding sound effects and a crash zoom does emphasize that emotion, adding in this bursting animation gives the clip the final oomph. Here's how I do it. I like to use Adobe Fresco on my tablet, and I create a canvas that is 1920 by 1080 pixels in sRGB. You can change the dimensions based on your video ratio and quality. Then I change the background to a contrasting color. Since I'm using white to draw, I chose the color black. Adobe Fresco has a ton of brushes for you to choose from, and for my style, I usually go for a sketching pencil. Let's begin with the first layer. I typically start my animations with the frame that contains the main object. In this case, it's this spiky star that eventually breaks into smaller points and dots. For me, it's easier to envision how the main object breaks apart rather than starting with the fragmented pieces. After drawing the first frame, I go into the Layers tab and reduce the opacity, between 25 to 50%. Then I add a layer and draw the next frame, which contains a movement and change from the first. I repeat this until I am done, and make sure to change all your layers back to full opacity once you're finished. To put this animation into Premiere Pro, you can toggle off the background and export each frame as a transparent PNG. After importing your animation into Premiere Pro and placing it on top of your footage, you can toggle on different blend modes to create cool effects. You can find blend mode under Effect Controls, Opacity, Blend Mode. If you exported your animation or frames with a black background, you can toggle on Add, which essentially takes away all the black in the image and make the background transparent, leaving only what you drew. I also like using Color Dodge, which causes your animation, whatever colors you use, to interact with the colors of your video footage. And voila, that's how I animate little doodles into my videos. I also like handwriting titles and text overlays, which adds to the vibe of a scrapbook or journal. For titles like this, I like to make three frames, which I do by tracing over the original frame two times. And for titles that look like I'm writing in real time, what I do is I screen record my handwriting on my tablet, making sure to write on a black background and that the drawing is fully in frame. Then I add the screen recording to my timeline in Premiere Pro. I crop the video so only the text is visible,
and then toggle light in for the blend mode, which removes the black background.
Lastly, I adjust the speed of the writing and add in a pencil sound effect. This really adds a personal touch. There's something quite charming about adding handwriting to your art. It almost feels like a one-of-a-kind signature. And once you get a hang of the basics, you can start experimenting with more typefaces and motions and shapes, illustrate with full-on color. And for a video about me visiting Vietnam for the first time ever, I wanted to highlight the vibrant hues and unique fonts of Vietnam. So I hand-drew these animations to overlay on top of my footage and intermission cards of Vietnamese food. Lastly, you can draw your own unique transitions. I love everything celestial and starry, so I had this idea of creating this rotating star that opens up little by little, eventually to the first frame of a video. For this, you want to use black for your background and white for your brush. The canvas guides in Adobe Fresco are super useful for this, so make sure to have that toggled on. After choosing the shape you want to use, like a star, heart, triangle, circle, etc., start from the center and draw the frames of an expanding shape until it completely takes up the frame, ending with a frame of all white. Then export the animation and drag it into your Premiere Pro timeline. For transitioning from a black screen, place the animation on top of your video footage and select the blend mode darken. Readjust the speed and timing of the transition as necessary. And ta-da! you have your own unique opening transition. You can also take that same animation and use it for transitioning in between clips. Set the blend mode to color dodge or add, duplicate the clip, and reverse the second copy to create a transition for within your video. By combining these tips, you can use hand-drawn animations to give your videos a personal flair and cozy touch, all with Adobe Premiere Pro and Adobe Fresco. I hope you're inspired to try new things and start doodling. Let me know what you want to draw and animate in the comments below, and I'll catch you in the next video.